Hey there! Have you ever wondered how the flintlock works, like the Miniman? The flintlock is a type of firing mechanism for early handheld firearms, like muskets. As its name implies, the firing system utilizes a spark created by striking a piece of flint onto a piece of hardened steel. Now let's look at the firing sequence together. Early flintlocks were muzzle-loading smoothbores. The shooter must measure the correct amount of powder charge first, then pour the measured gunpowder down the barrel. Next, he must place the patch, usually made of paper or cloth, and the bullet, usually a lead ball, inside the muzzle. Then, the shooter must ram the lead ball down the barrel with a ramrod. The shooter should check the cock to make sure that it is in the half-cock position. Opening the hammer, or the friction, exposes the flash pin. Pour priming powder into the pin and close the steel, or the friction. The musket is now loaded and ready to fire. To fire the musket, the shooter will pull the cock to the full cock position and pull the trigger, sending the cock forward, causing the flint to strike the frizzen or hammer, forcing the frizzen to open, creating spark down into the priming powder held in the pen. Ignition of the priming powder produces a flash, which ignites a main charge that vent in the side of the barrel. The pressure created by the explosion pushes the bullet out of the barrel and toward the shooter's target. The flintlock mechanism is simpler and cheaper to produce compared to the earlier matchlock and wheellock firearm. It is also more reliable. The matchlock is difficult to use in windy and wet weather. The live match can accidentally ignite stored gunpowder. The wheellock was prone to jam, and the iron pyrite wore out quickly. The advantages of the flintlock were obvious. By early 18th century, it had superseded both the matchlock and wheellocks. Thank you for checking out my video. If you enjoyed watching my channel, please subscribe. Thank you in advance, and see you next time.